Well, I bought some more stuff from Ubiquiti again. One of these I owned previously, which was the UniFi Dream Machine, and then I also got this UniFi Dream Router. Any idea what the difference is between these two and which one you might want to buy? Well, let's take a look. So coming on over to the Dream Router specs, you can see it's got both 2.4 gigahertz and 5 gigahertz, which is pretty much the norm. And it has the standard 1 gig WAN port and 4 LAN ports. Now it has 128 gigs of internal storage and a micro SD card memory slot for expansion. Now note here, it does require a micro SD card that is at least 128 gigs. Now this is $199, and if we come over to the Dream Machine, it is $299. So what is the difference between these two for $100? Now it's interesting, for $100 less, you do get multiple PoE ports. Also, this is a Wi-Fi 6 router, and the Dream Machine is just a Wi-Fi 5 router. Now, looking at the data sheets, the Dream Machine and the Dream Router are almost exactly the same size, and weight is slightly different. The router is a little bit heavier, and the biggest difference is the processor here. So looking at the Dream Router, we have a dual-core Cortex A53 at 1.35 gigahertz. Coming over to the Dream Machine, it is a ARM Cortex A57 instead of the 53, and it is a quad core instead of a dual core at 1.7 gigahertz. Now, what that allows you to do is to run more applications or more inspection on the connections and more firewall rules without basically overloading the router, where it just can't handle any more rules or applications. Now, taking a look at the max transmit power here, you get a little bit more on the 2.4 gigahertz on the Dream Router over the Dream Machine. However, the Dream Machine has a little bit more transmit power for the 5 gigahertz spectrum. Now, both have dual band quad polarity antennas. And unfortunately, when looking at these two data sheets, they're not exact line for line. So over here, we see beamforming, and over here, I do not see beamforming. Now, what it really comes down to is what you want to spend on a router and the security features as well as applications within the UniFi ecosystem on what you want to run on your router. So to show you what I'm talking about, let's take a look at this here. I have the Dream Router selected here, and let's say we wanted to run a phone or two on it, say two phones and one HD camera, and oh, looks like you can't do more than a single 4K camera on the Dream Router here. So if we uncheck the talk, one 4K camera or four HD cameras. And let's say that we added a extra access point, and the console only supports a maximum of two apps running at the same time. So I would have to give up either Protect or Talk. Now let's go over to the Dream Machine, and you can see that Protect, Talk, and Access are not accessible. However, we can put like 40 access points on this guy here. Let's go over to the Dream Router and see if we can do the same. Now only like 15, and let's put a camera or two on there. Yeah, so that you can do more on the Dream Router over the Dream Machine, with the exception of if you had multiple access points, like 40 access points, you could do that on the Dream Machine. Then of course, if you come over to the UDM Pro or UDM SE, then you can pretty much load these up, 75 access points or something ridiculous. And let's see, Protect, a couple of those, and Talk, a couple phones, wow. And we're not even barely putting a dent in it. So I hope that answers your questions on which router that you might want to purchase, whether it is the Dream Machine or the Dream Router, and where that extra $100 might go to. Or you might want to just consider getting a UDM Pro or UDM Pro SE and then purchasing a access point separately to be able to run all those applications. Now, if you're researching about Ubiquiti equipment in general, or if you're just new to Ubiquiti, then check out these videos over here in this playlist.